Saturday, free and clear, mind you. And that would have been a blessing just by itself. But oh no, oh no. There's more to the story. And to me, this was what was so, wow, so powerful. Not just did they give this man a car, but they gave him insurance for the car, paid for 1 year, and a local dealership, car dealership, said, well, hey, we're gonna not just do this, but we're gonna give him free oil changes for that car for a year. So we're gonna sweeten the deal a little bit. And you know what, by that one act of kindness, that one act, it changed that man's life forever. So yes, in fact, I'm not telling you, buy cars and give them away, or buy houses and give them away. I'm not saying this. If you want to, do it. Change somebody's life. If you want to invest in people that need it the most, you know what? It shouldn't take very long for you to find people just like that that need a little helping hand. We'll be back, ladies and gentlemen, right after this. Don't go too far. Again, robertchristianshow.com. We are back, ladies and gentlemen. Hey, it is great to have you with us and joining us. I do want to remind everybody, however, that for the next 2 weeks, I'm going to be taking off for vacation period. And yeah, I'm going to miss everybody. But you know, as a matter of fact, last year, I remember. How do I remember things like this? But last year, I so remember. I was in my second or third day of vacation time, and I was getting a little antsy. I was a little bit antsy. I was like, you know what? Okay. I've got to cover this news story. I've got to talk about this. I've got to address it. I got to get this out there. And I was so frustrated, literally frustrated. Almost with my palms sweating, frustrated, because I wanted to share a news story. I wanted to share an idea, something that popped into my head. I was like, ah, that is an aha moment. People need to know about this. Anyway, to say the least, last year I was steadily working behind the scenes. Although I was off the air, I was still behind the scenes doing graphic work for the show, doing promotional stuff. And you know, it took a lot out of me last year just to do that. But I was like, you know, hey, I've got to do this. do you ever do that? Do you ever go home from work but you take your work with you? Hey, come on, I'm not the only one. So, but that's what happened last year. And I was frustrated because there was so much more that I wanted to share. There was so much more that was going on in the news, and I was getting so aggravated and thinking, you know what? I've got to get this out there. I've got to talk about this. And oh, my heavens, no. So, this year, To the contrary. But I'll be on Facebook upon occasion. Upon occasion. I will be on, what is it? On Twitter upon occasion. And I will be doing the Twitter. I'll be doing the emails. As long as that it's not business related, really. Because my plan is to take off on vacation and say, you know what? Hey, I deserve it. I deserve time away. So, yeah. So I'll be taking off for the next 2 weeks for the live show. But I can only hope, oh Lord, would this ever be a pipe dream to me? That 3 days into to my vacation or my downtime, which I do it twice a year. But you know what? I would be so happy to be able to say, you know what? There isn't anything on the news today that I want to talk about. Do you think that would ever happen?
No.
Probably not. But you know what? I still think, you know, look. Vacation time is just that. It should be vacation time, and I shouldn't be hunting up work, hunting up news stories and all this, and trying to remember things like that when I'm on. No. Oh, no. So this year, probably not. Probably. So if you miss us for the next 2 weeks, hey, you know where I will be. I will be somewhere in outer space somewhere. Spaced out. You know what I mean? Know what I mean, Vern? No. We're staying close to home. And I'm just going to enjoy time off and do my own thing. I think that's important. You know, and to me, that's not outlandish. That's not death-defying. Just staying home and doing absolutely nothing when it comes to work. But it will be a treat. It really will. Well, last year, that's what the plan was, too. But you know what, folks? The longer and longer that I go with this, I get confronted every now and then by people who ask me, you know, hey, when are you going to retire? And you know what? The day that I retire, that is going to be the day that I will be found walking into the sunset with my partner on my side, or by my side, and our doggy walking right along with us, and here I will be dragging my microphone through the sand into the bright sunset of a day gone by and all that noise. And oh, doesn't that just sound delicious? So that's what I'm going to be doing. Actually, I have no plan on retirement. It'll be great, but for what it's worth. But folks, we have had this year fantastic and powerful guests that have come on that have shared their visions, their goals, their ideas with you. From Judy Shepherd, the mother of Matthew Shepherd, her son was murdered in Wyoming because he was gay, if you remember that story. We've had his mother on. Miss Coco Peru, a fantastic comedian, funny lady. We were blessed to have her on. Oh my goodness, Dan Dotson from Storage Wars, USA, LA. We've had him on. Oh my goodness, he and his wife both. Renee, hey, we got to get Renee back on. From Storage Wars, Renee. Now he and Casey, there's something else. But you know, and then politicians, and then people just like you. People like you that have an opinion, and although some people's opinion may oppose mine, or I oppose them, right? Or we oppose a lot of things together, but we want to repurpose anger into something that could be powerful and something that could be life-changing. That's where it is. You know what? It takes an awful lot, ladies and gentlemen, to make me angry, to make me mad. It takes a lot. Because I prefer not to be angry. We have anger everywhere. And Americans right now are really at a cusp. They're at a very vital point in American history. And I don't think, honestly, that the American people are going to be sitting back, taking it in as stride or as just something that just so happens, and consider this as the norm. Folks, hate is never going to be the norm. Anger is only for a season. But then when you do something outlandish and you help somebody in their life, you encourage them, you do something maybe that you have never in your life done before, you know what? That sets the bar a little bit higher, then, doesn't it? Because it shows you that even at the end of it, you still come out on top. If you're the recipient, it means, guess what? Somebody had faith in you. Somebody had confidence in you. Somebody wanted to give you something. You know what? And I love giving people stuff. I do. I like giving people something to think about. I like giving somebody the time of day. I like giving people the opportunity in media that perhaps that they would not have. I like hearing from folks. And I love our fan base. I think, though, that we could grow it. I think that we can grow this media. I think that we can do much bigger and better things. But it takes people like you, really, that help us to keep going. And I can't do it by myself. You know, I work countless hours during the week. If it's not PR, if it's not advertising, if it's not, you know, booking of guests, et cetera, et cetera. You know, there's always something. And mentally, hey, I'm all there. I'm saying, yes, you know, let's do this. Here's something that's got to be done. But physically, I'm like, oh, my goodness, I could use 10 people. 10! To help to orchestrate some of the things that need to be done. Drew, our co-host, love the guy. Funny, he is. He is a tall drink of water. Yes, he is. I give him that. I tell you what, when he was a kid, he must have ate the box full of Wheaties. Because he's on up there, yep. He must have liked the Jolly Green Giant in the can. I think it's great. And then I also want to remember Michael Cagle. Good guy, good friend. And I don't know if Drew knows Michael Cagle, but Michael, a fantastic singer, came from Nashville, worked there. He did some musical scenes in Las Vegas. And now he calls Washington home. But I'm honored even to be able to meet him. And he did after all of this time. And I am so glad I was on his case about this. Talking about branching out and getting out of the comfort zone. You know what he did? Michael, I love you, but I gotta tell everybody this. A little bit about Mr. Michael. You see, there was a song by Leonard Cohen called Hallelujah, that Leonard Cohen had written several years ago. And I started listening to this song, and I was like, you know what? Okay, that sounds nice. Have you ever done that? That sounds nice. That sounds good. Okay. Let's hear some more. Oh, that's lovely. That piece goes together quite well. Ah. And then you start thinking in your head. This is where it gets dangerous. Start thinking in your head. I know somebody that could sing that song and do it justice. Well, I got a hold of Michael. How'd you guess? I got a hold of Michael. And I told him, I said, hey, Michael, hey, listen to me, and I'm going to tell this to you. Hey, I had a proclamation of declaration. That made it important. Well, at least to me it was. So I was emphasizing the construction of the idea. I was planting. You see what I was doing? I was planting a seed. Oh God, that's great. I was planting a seed, and I said, hey, Michael, listen, I have a declaration. I have a proclamation of declaration for you. I want to rock your world, Michael. Hey, there is a song. Like he hadn't ever heard the song before. But Michael, hey, there is a song that you need to sing. You do. But look, he can sing the paint off a barn door. But for me, oh no, I could make it probably run a little bit. Maybe a little run away from me is what it would do. But Michael, now, he's something else. See, some people are talented. I'm not talented in singing. I just need to become an auctioneer. That's it. I'll become an auctioneer. But I told Michael, I said, you know what? There's a song. And I told him the name of it. And I said, I want you to sing this. I want you to rehearse this and start singing it. And as a matter of fact, last year, he was on a CD. As I remember, it was a CD. During the Christmas season. And that was a song that he chose to put on there. And I was elated. Because I've got the utmost respect for Michael, for his musical ability, but also for the song. Leonard Cohen, he was something else. And I've always said that that one song, though, that was one of the most inspiring and one of the most noted and needed inspirational songs of our generation and of our lifetime. Love this song. So Michael, oh my goodness, here he is, give him that microphone. He sang the song. And I could not hardly believe my ears. And to me, it was fantastic. Now, I don't know if I had really any part with Michael singing that, or if I have any part with somebody else deciding, you know what, I want to go into media too. Not social media, but I want to go into media too. I want to go into radio. I want to go into television. I want to learn about this stuff. Hey, I'm inspired. Now, folks, at the end of today's show, and here we are, I'll tell you who inspired me in media. And I can never thank this man enough for being that inspiration. And that was Larry King. Strangely, I've been compared to him. That's kind of weird. I mean, I get the glasses bit. Yeah, okay, I've got that going on. The suspenders, I haven't got that far yet. Maybe I should start doing that. But it was his style. And I consider it really a blessing, an honor to be compared to him. Because he was my mentor. And I'll never forget. One of the things that he said was, in order to look good, your guests have to look good. He liked things right on target. He enjoyed a challenge, as always. And although he made a name for himself, he made a brand for himself. I've never really tried to imitate him, but to say that I've learned a lot from him, learned a lot about his career. And folks, that makes life worth living for me. I like to learn something about everybody and to be able to encourage, to strengthen, to, you know, even Drew, our co-host, you know, I've learned a lot about him. And in last week's show, for those that might have missed it, if you missed it, naughty. But I said last week, I was talking to Senator Bob Hasegawa. I said, you know what? Listen, even Drew was on that show. I said, look, here's the deal. I would really consider, after talking in that interview, I told Senator Bob, I said, you know what? That almost makes me want to run for public office. Almost. And Drew thought that was the funniest thing, and so did the senator. But you know what, folks? It is people that give you good ideas. It is people that motivate you. Those are the people to watch in your life and to keep close to you and close to your heart. Folks, I'm Robert Christian. We're ready to wind up the rest of the show. On behalf of the Robert Christian Show, ladies and gentlemen, as always, find somebody, please, and love them. On the web, robertchristianshow.com. We'll see you next time. So long.